Hello everyone, welcome to AptiPlus Academy for Civil Services. This is a special video on the MPR, that is monthly policy review. And this is very important initiative because MPR is very important for your prelims and mains examination. So this monthly policy review is for the month of February. Actually, whatever news that has been reported in the entire month of the February used to be published in March. So we are discussing the edition in March, but the entire news pertains to the February, right? So this the news that is important in the February edition, we're discussing that, and the most important news would be discussed comprehensively so that will help you in the prelims and mains examination. So before I proceed, just to make you aware that PRS Legislative Research releases MPR, and this is a think tank, an independent research institute, which aims to strengthen the legislative process in the country. So you can read more detail about this and you can visit their website as well. We'll start the news or article. The first is National Urban Digital Mission and Digital Initiatives. So this type of initiative is again very important for the prelims examination. A two statement question can be directly asked in the examination. And at the same time, if you're writing an essay paper, you can have some fodder point that can help you giving an extra edge in the essay, right? So let's see what are the important content from this article or news. So the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs, they have launched an initiative to promote digital technologies jahan pe identify ki jayegi important issues like urban planning and governance. So these are the key area upon which the initiative has been taken by the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Shri Hardeep Puri is the minister for it. Like talking about the things that has been included in this initiative, the first is National Urban Digital Mission, also known as NUDM. Second is Indian Urban Data Exchange. Ye sari cheezon ki formulation hogi, and these things are again very important that can be a part of your questions, right? The Smart Code Platform, and the last is City Innovation Exchange Program, right? So ye char component hai. We'll see each component one by one so that it give you a comprehensive understanding about the topic. So the first is National Urban Digital Mission, also known as NUDM, right? So NUDM se kya kya important point aapko janna hai. So NUDM seeks to create a shared digital infrastructure for urban area jahan pe jo consolidated digital initiatives hai ministry ki, that would be addressed by the local challenges. So the entire aim of this initiative is to address the local challenges faced by the citizen of that particular concerned location. Now the second would be governing principle, which will be similar to the line of National Urban Innovation Track. So this was also important, and government has taken this initiative before as well. It announced this on 2019 itself. So aap isko bhi collaborative efforts ke taur pe agar aapne general studies paper 2 mein likh rahe hain to ye cheez bhi include kar sakte hain. Now talking about NUIS, this is intended to identify the urban challenges. So here the ministry is trying to incorporate the local challenges, but the initiative of NUIS aims to cater and identify the urban challenges and solve them at the speed using digital technologies and infrastructures. So technology would be again aided by the infrastructure, and at the same time that would be given the resolution, the best possible resolution with the upgraded technology. So this is the rationale behind the National Urban Digital Mission. Now moving ahead with the second one, that is Indian Urban Data Exchange. So as the name suggests, that this would be more of a comprehensive data exchange. So this seeks to create an open source interface that would allow the urban local bodies, jitne bhi hamare ULBs hai, urban local bodies hai, they would share, request, access that database related to cities, urban governance and service delivery. So agar aap baat kare khas karke local area mein, where have municipalities are there, and in urban city also we have corporations, right? In many cities like Indore ko jis tarah se abhi they have been awarded as the best cleanest city. So the urban jo city wahan pe jo municipal corporation hai, khas karke Indore municipal corporation, they are doing the commendable job. So is tarah se khas karke jo data exchange hai, that definitely help the delivery centers and the municipalities to provide a good service to the citizen. Now we have Smart Code Platform. This is the third one. This call for the repository open sources code for the application and the urban governance. So again, a repository would be created that would be helping the people to get the application, and at the same time the main aim is to improve the e-governance, right? So this would be an open source platform that would be freely available. Possible modification and redistribution would be there under the smart code platform. So ye kuch teen important hai. The last one is also very significant. This called for CITR Innovation Exchange Program, CIEP. So CIEP ki baat kare, so this was launched to enable the citizen to design, test, deliver innovation and address the urban challenges. So what citizen is doing in many municipalities, what like talking about the South India, like Mysuru, Madurai. So these city actually they have application where citizen can have their grievances on the app. If you talk about Delhi, like Delhi mein ek bahut important initiative li gayi thi, street lighting ko lekar ke. So the people used to file a complaint with the government that this particular street do not have the street lighting. So accordingly government know that which particular area has to be given the proper street lighting. So is tarah ke kuch important innovation exchange program jo hai wahan pe citizen plus government ki contribution bahut important hoti hai. Now the platform will operate under the smart city mission. This is a mission which was earlier started by the central government, and there was 400 startup with 215 solution across 100 smart city registered in February 21, right? So there are many cities government is trying to incorporate as number of smart cities that they can have, and smart city has a minimum criteria and the facilities that would be provided to them. So smart cities ki apni criteria hai, apni ranking hai jo ki government usko deti hai. Now moving to the second news, that RBI announces liquidity measure. So this is again an important point that you must understand, because liquidity measures by RBI has a very significant role. So the Reserve Bank of India has announced certain measures that effectively that liquidity positions bank and non-banking financial companies going to have, right? Now talking about the measures that was taken under the initiative. So first is restoration of the CRR, jo cash reserve ratio hai. That was reduced from 4% to 3%. Initially it was 4%, but RBI ne isko 3% kiya. Now this was allowed till March 2021. Aur CRR ki agar baat kare, this is a proportion of deposit that bank has to maintain in cash. So this is something which banks maintain in cash. If you don't know, make sure you are aware of basic concepts of the economics. Now RBI had decided to restore the CRR to 4% in two phases, right? Now the bank has to maintain the CRR by 3.5% starting from March 2021 and 4% from May 2021, right? So this is something they're trying to ease out the banking processes always and giving some relief to the banking sectors. Now extension of relaxation under MSF, jo marginal standing facility hoti hai, that was increased from 2% to 3%, right? और अगर इसकी बात करें, दिस वॉज बेसिकली द रिलैक्सेशन वॉज इनिशियली वैलिड फॉर June 30, 2020. नाउ इसको एक्सटेंड कर दिया गया है March 2021 तक के लिए. MSF की अगर बात करें, वॉट इज MSF? राइट, बैंक कैन बोरो ओवरनाइट फ्रॉम द RBI. सो ओवरनाइट फैसिलिटी मिलती है बैंक को कि ओवरनाइट वो बोरो कर सकते हैं बाय डिपिंग इनटू देयर स्टैट्यूटरी लिक्विडिटी रेशियो. SLR पर डिप करके दे कैन बाय ओवरनाइट अंडर द MSF फैसिलिटी. If you talk about SLR, SLR hoti kya, ek proportion of deposits hai that the bank has to maintain in liquid asset, right? Maine aapko pehle bataya that the CRR has to be maintained in cash and statutory liquidity ratio has to be maintained in liquid, that is gold, government securities and above the CRR, right? So the relaxation under MSF has been extended till September 30, 2021. So these are some of the important instrument that is being used by the RBI to regulate the economy of this country. Now Major Port Authority Bill 2020, this is again a landmark bill that calls for a reform in the port authorities or the port, basically jitne India mein port ki regulation hai usko lekar ke. So the bill replaced the Major Port Trust Act 1963 and it provide for the regulation. First is regulation, operation and planning of major ports in India, and it provide for the greater autonomy of these ports, right? So regulate karna, operate karna aur plan karna kis tarah se India ki jo overall ports hai usko expand kiya ja sake, quality improve ki ja sake. Now major ports in India, if you talk about the ports in India, the major ports include Chennai, the first and the basically the largest port Chennai, Kochi, Jawaharlal Nehru Port Kandla, Calcutta, Mumbai, New Mangalore, Morbu, Paradip, and VO Chidambaranam and Vishakhapatnam. So these are some of the important ports that are there in India. So make sure aap inske naam jaane, aap map work mein bhi iske locations dekh sakte hain. Now the bill consists of board of port authority. The bill call for a board port authority hogi that would be there in the administration. Each ports mein ye hongi jo call karegi administration ke liye, control ke liye and management of this port. So this is again the most important point that you have to note, and this can be a very important part in the prelims examination. Now key features of the bill ki baat kare, which I have told you in the beginning, board of मेजर पोर्ट अथॉरिटी अंडर 1963 जो एक्ट है वहाँ पे जो मेजर पोर्ट्स हो दैट वुड बी मैनेज्ड बाय द रिस्पेक्टिव बोर्ड ट्रस्ट. पहले बोर्ड ट्रस्ट इसको जो पोर्ट ट्रस्ट है वो इसको रेगुलेट करती थी. नाउ दे वुड बी अपॉइंटेड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. और जो बिल है ये कॉन्स्टिट्यूट करती है कि जो बोर्ड ऑफ मेजर पोर्ट्स अथॉरिटी ऑफ ईच पोर्ट्स टू रिप्लेस द एग्जिस्टिंग पोर्ट ट्रस्ट, राइट? सो दिस इज समथिंग दैट वुड बी वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट. Now fixing of rates, agar baat kare 1963 ki, so the act establishes tariff authority for major ports to fix the scale of rates for assessing and services available at the ports. Aur kuch important cheeze hongi jo ki board of ports authority ko dekhni hogi, aur khas karke jo aise committees hain they would be appointed and the board would determine the rate of services performed at the ports. Kya kya services perform ki gayi hai, excess and the uses of port assets, or teesri had different classes of goods and services version, and among others. So these are the main work or the assignment that would be given to the board of the port authorities. Now adjudicating board hogi yahan pe, agar koi bhi problems hoti hai education ko lekar ke ya fir kisi tarah ke grievances hain, so there would be an adjudicatory body to replace the existing tariff authority of the major ports. If you talk about the functions of the adjudicating board, this include functioning of the existing tariff authority, adjudicating on the dispute claim related to rights obligations of the major ports. So these are the work that is assigned to the adjudicating board, and exam mein aapse questions mein bhi yahan pe sawal puche ja sakte hain. Now draft policy framework for the blue economy, because government has inclined and they are willing to have a blue economy which ensures a lot of prosperity to the country. So the Ministry of Earth Sciences has released a draft framework for India blue economy. Jo blue economy hai wo comprise karti hai oceanic resources, man made economic infrastructures and maritime and also coastal zones ko. ये जो पॉलिसी है खास करके ब्लू इकोनॉमी की, दैट आउटलाइन द स्ट्रेटजी दैट द गवर्नमेंट कैन अडॉप्ट टू यूटिलाइज द ओशियनिक सोर्सेज फॉर सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट, राइट? सो टू इंश्योर द सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट ऑफ द ओशियन, दिस प्रोग्राम और दिस ड्राफ्ट पॉलिसी फ्रेमवर्क इज गोइंग टू हेल्प द कंट्री. नाउ क्या क्या एम है इस फ्रेमवर्क की? द फर्स्ट, इट एम्स टू इन्हांस द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ ब्लू इकोनॉमी टू द GDP. जो हमारी GDP में कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन है उसको इंक्रीज करना. The second is to improve the life of the coastal communities. Third is to preserve the marine biodiversity. Because of the pollution, jo marine diversity ki jo populations hain, wo bahut zyada deteriorate kar rahi hain. Now maintaining the security of the maritime area and resources. So security of the maritime area is again very significant and important. Now some key recommendations of the draft policy. So yahan pe baat ki gayi hai jo contribution hai blue economy ki, the size of the blue economy in India is estimated to around 4% of the GDP, but this may be higher if reliable methodology is being used. Now a new robust mechanism must be devised to collect the reliable data regarding the blue economy. Now definitely if the government trying to increase the share of the GDP of the blue economy, so they need to work comprehensively so that this target are being achieved. Now coastal marine spatial planning and tourism. So if you talk about the coastal maritime spatial planning approach, this should be adopted by managing the economic or the resources that maps and data on the environment characteristic, geography, present utilization and available resources. So basically main iska aim hai spatial planning ki, एक मैप पर प्रोवाइड करना, एक GPS सर्विसेज प्रोवाइड करना, सो दैट नेविगेशन की जो चीज़ें हैं वो इजी हो सके, राइट? मैप, द मैप नेविगेशन इन इंडिया एंड टूरिज्म कैन बी ईज आउट. नाउ सस्टेनेबल मरीन फिसेस, यहाँ पे कुछ जो प्रोग्राम जो रिकमेंडेशंस दी गई है दैट कॉल्स फॉर new national policy on the sector and establishing a legal institutional framework for effective management of the marine fisheries, exploring and deployment of dedicated satellite system for the management and regulation of fisheries and allied activities. Now, legal and regulatory reform. So it called for inaction of the legislative framework for the development and regulation of blue economy. Or isme jo central legislation hai, that called for the management and regulation of fisheries related by revising the scope of Marine Fisheries Regulation Act. Right. So these are something that regulation would also be adopted to ensure the good governance in the blue economy. Now, introducing the central legislation for management of aquatic diseases along with the quarantine and certification services that would be also provided under this draft policy. Now, draft national strategy on blockchain. So blockchain has been news. और ब्लॉकचेन से अगर बात करें तो प्रिलिम्स में ज़रूर आपसे सवाल पूछे जाएंगे. मेक श्योर आप इसके जो भी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स हैं उसको अच्छे से समझ लें. सो द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी रिलीजेस द ड्राफ्ट स्ट्रेटजी ऑन ब्लॉकचेन. सो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज ब्लॉकचेन? ब्लॉकचेन एक डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड लेजर टेक्नोलॉजी है जो कि बेस्ड करती है शेयर लेजर्स बिटवीन द पार्टीज इन्वॉल्व इन द बिजनेस ट्रांजेक्शन. सो एक इकोसिस्टम क्रिएट होती है वेयर द टेक्नोलॉजी हेल्प to you know, reach each and every out the components of it. Agar baat kare data structure ki that is used in the blockchain, it maintain an unchainable record of transitions in a time sequential manner. So everything has been taken in the record aur ye kabhi bhi kisi bhi tarah se basically isko destroy nahi ki ja sakti hai. And it eliminate the need of central entity to validate the transition. Koi central entity ki zarurat nahi padegi transition ko validate karne ke liye. तो मिनिस्टर ने यह नोट किया है कि ये जो टेक्नोलॉजी है डेफिनेटली दिस विल इम्प्रूव द ट्रांसपेरेंसी इम्यूटेबिलिटी एफिकेसी ऑफ द मैनेजिंग ट्रांजेक्शन. जिस तरह से इंडिया में ट्रांजेक्शन हैंडल की जा रही है दैट इज बीइंग हैंडल बाय द आरबीआई. वहाँ पे अलग अलग बैचेस में एनईएफटी आरटीजीएस के सेटलमेंट्स होती हैं बट इस तरह की जो टेक्नोलॉजी है दैट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प एंड दिस विल डेफिनेटली इम्प्रूव द ट्रांसपेरेंसी एफिकेसी इन द मैनेजिंग द ट्रांजेक्शन ऑफ द कंट्री. तो अगर पोटेंशियल की बात करें सो बहुत सारे डोमेन्स में इसकी पोटेंशियल है दैट इंक्लूड प्रॉपर्टी रिकॉर्ड मैनेजमेंट आइडेंटिफाइंग मैनेजमेंट सप्लाई चेन एंड ई वोटिंग. सो दीज आर द सेक्टर अपॉन विच खास करके ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी यूज की जा सकती है. तो आपसे प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन में ये पूछा जा सकता है कि विच आर द एरिया अपॉन विच द ब्लॉकचेन टेक्नोलॉजी कैन बी यूज और इसमें ये सारे ऑप्शन होंगे. इस तरह से यूपीएससी ने जीपीएस के बारे में ऑलरेडी क्वेश्चन 2017 में पूछे हुए हैं. इफ यू नॉट चेक द क्वेश्चन डू चेक इट आउट, यू विल गेट द आइडिया हाउ यूपीएससी फ्रेम्स द क्वेश्चन. सो मेक श्योर यू अंडरस्टैंड इट वेल व्हेन क्वेश्चन इज गोइंग टू सिक्योर 2 marks फॉर योर प्रीलिम्स एग्जामिनेशन. राइट. So the blockchain can add value to e-governance as well. Now, what are the challenges in adopting the blockchain technology? First is the scalability and transition speed. That is the first challenge. Second is the data security and privacy. When the technology advances, the privacy concerns looms around, right? The third is standardization and the interoperability. And the last is a skilled manpower, because to handle the advanced technology, we equally need the advanced manpower to control and handle it. Now, key features of the draft strategy. First, it's called for the national level blockchain framework, जहाँ पे एक स्ट्रैटेजी प्रपोज की जाएगी. इस स्ट्रैटेजी के अंदर एक इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर होस्ट की जाएगी, प्लेटफॉर्म बनाई जाएगी दैट वुड क्रिएटेड अक्रॉस द मल्टीपल जोन इन द कंट्री. और ये जो स्ट्रैटेजी है दैट पोजेस क्रिएशन फॉर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर ब्लॉकचेन एंड नेशनल रिसोर्सेज रिकमेंडिंग ऑफरिंग ब्लॉकचेन सर्विसेज दैट इज ऑल्सो नोन एज बैस. सो ब्लॉकचेन एज अ सर्विसेज, ब्लॉकचेन एज अ सर्विसेज क्या है, ये ऑफर करती है क्लाउड बेस्ड सर्विसेज बिल्डिंग फॉर होस्टिंग ब्लॉकचेन एंड द एप्लीकेशंस. So these are some of the important key features of the draft strategy. The second is integration of the national level services. Yahan pe jo e-sign hai, online services providing the instant signing of document, e-parman jo authenticated services hai across the government applications and DigiLocker jo ki government ne kafi pehle start kiya tha, jisme aap bahut sare apne important documents ko PDF format mein ya JPG format mein online rakh sakte hain. So online services to access the document was issued by the government agencies. Now there would be a capacity building that would be there. So the strategy not for the blockchain technology needs to be promoted by conducting a short term courses on the boot camps. So government skill development ke liye boot camps chalegi taki logo ko bio khas karke jo technology hai usse cheeze mil sake jo blockchain technology hai. and the strategy proposes a sandbox. So development and testing of the applications for offering the virtual training. And the sandbox provide for an environment which allows the market participants to test new products, services, business model, and customer in the controlled environment. So this would be the capacity building under the blockchain technology that very soon government should be working upon. Now, the other news or article, you can say it's Arbitration and Conciliation Amendment Bill. So it has been amended several times, but this time some important point you have to note. The Arbitration and Reconciliation Amendment Bill 2021, this was passed by the Lok Sabha. और ये जो पूरी बिल है दैट सीक्स टू अमेंड द आर्बिट्रेशन एंड रिकॉलिएशन एक्ट 1996 2017 में भी इसको गवर्नमेंट ने इसमें कुछ अमेंडमेंट की थी बट अगेन देयर इज अ अमेंडमेंट द एक्ट कंटेंट प्रोविजंस रिगार्डिंग द डोमेस्टिक एंड इंटरनेशनल आर्बिट्रेटर्स जो खास करके इंटरनेशनल और डोमेस्टिक आर्बिट्रेटर्स हैं उनकी डेफिनेशन को डिफाइन की गई है फॉर कंडक्टिंग द कंसिलिएशन प्रोसीडिंग्स राइट नाउ व्हाट आर द की फीचर्स दैट हैव बीन इंक्लूडेड तो ऑटोमेटिक स्टे ऑन अवार्ड्स को किस तरह से कंट्रोल किया जाएगा तो 1996 की जो ऑर्डर है वो अलाउ करती है पार्टी को टू फाइल एंड सेट असाइड द आर्बिट्रल अवार्ड राइट सो गिवन एन ऑर्डर ऑफ द आर्बिट्रल प्रोटेजिंग बट 2015 की जो एक्ट थी दैट अमेंड टू स्टे एन आर्बिट्रल अवार्ड दैट वुड नॉट बी ऑटोमेटिकली स्टेड नहीं होगा बट इसमें एक एप्लीकेशन फाइल करनी होगी टू द कोर्ट एंड सेट असाइड द आर्बिट्रल अवार्ड सो दिस इज समथिंग विच इज अगेन अ सिग्निफिकेंट पॉइंट Now, the bill specify jo arbitral award hogi that would be provided during the presidency of setting aside the application. If agar court satisfied hai, kuch important cheezon ko dhyan mein rakhte hue, then it can be automatically. First is relevant arbitration agreement or contract, making of award that was included and affected by the fault corruptions. And these changes would be affected from October 23, 2015. Now, qualifications of arbitrator rakhi gayi hain. The act specifies certain qualifications. Jo arbitrators honge, first requirement is that under the schedule included of the arbiter must be an advocate and under the Advocate Act 1961, right? Aur uske paas 10 year ki experiences honi chahiye. Second, and officers of the Indian Legal Services would be appointed, would be there as a part of this. Now, the bill removed the schedule for the arbitrators and state of the qualification experiences. Norms of the accreditation and arbitrator that would be specified. So these are the qualifications of the arbitrators that they have to basically, you know, these are the eligibility or the minimum criteria that is required. So qualifications, jo qualification arbitrators ke, uske baare mein bhi dhyan rakhe because this can be an important point. Now this was all about the edition. We have our special initiative called Daily Topic Wise News Analysis. Where I used to cover the news from the Hindu and Indian Express on daily basis. So you can watch this as well and you will save a lot of time. So this is a time where you're lacking with the lacking of time where you need to study more on the static portion. So because of the paucity of the time, what you can do, you can refer to our comprehensive daily news analysis that will help you to save a lot of time and devote your time in the static portion. So make sure you watch this. And if you like this video, the PRS edition, do not forget to subscribe Apti Plus Academy for Civil Services on YouTube. And if you like this video, do not forget to give thumbs up. And what you can do, you can share this video with your friends. That can help them as well. If you have any other concern, do let us know. We'll be more than happy to assist you. For time being, I'm signing off. Wish you all the best. Thank you so much for listening.